Our first day out on the trail, rather grueling, but we made it over the pass. Now we're headed down to Duck Lake.
Beautiful Duck Lake.
Which you are seeing as I speak. Anyway, wanted to get one video out of the way.
Yeah.
Say goodbye, Don Rolando.
Can we paraglide from here, Pete?
Ha! Let's give it a shot.
Okay.
This campsite number one, the next morning. I'm up, it's about 6 a.m. Trying to get things done early, break down camp. Having another grueling day hiking. And my partner's still in bed. Gonna have to roust him shortly. Does look like the Weezer's up. That's a surprise.
Weezer is up.
Yeah, I underestimated my partner. He's up. Nice Rolando.
Oh my God. This is a game. He put us on. Aquí. A la pasa.
O'clock in the evening.
Yeah.
Day two, starting to settle down. We have tunes, made camp again, feeling tired,
yeah.
But we're alive. Don Pedro's cooking up a little freeze-dried vegetarian chili. He's hungry, gonna eat it all. Quick howdy to the folks, Don Rolando.
Well,
just a little something.
Folks, evening. Here we are, day two. And yeah, a bit worn. But you know what? I think I'm getting svelte and gnarly. Come on, baby. I'm ready.
Thank you, Don Rolando. Well, I've got to get back to cooking. So, we'll see all you folks later.
Yeah. Thank you.
These are the times that try man's soul. About 6.5 hours into our hike today. Over Silver Pass, 10,900 feet. Coming down into Pocket Meadow. Beat as a wet puppy. Hurting shoulders, blisters, and my crotch itches. The whole nine yards. But we might have another hour to go. And just checking in. Than anybody out there who cares, we're still alive. Adios.
Yeah. Buenas tardes to everyone. Don Rolando here. Well, here we are on the JMT and Bear Creek heading up that way. I'll tell you, it's gnarly. For manly men only. And as you can see, it's one after another. Sheer beauty.
Morning of day six, after a completely brutal day five. Didn't make camp last night till after seven. Dead tired. Following this Bear Creek up all the way, up to Bear Ridge, where we will make a right-hand turn heading to Selden Pass. But I wanted to show you this view. Beautiful. Soaking my weary, blister-laden feet in Lake Marie. Oh man, I have no idea how good that feels. Oh, here's my other foot. Ah, jeez. Anyway, Lake Marie is just beautiful. There's nobody here. I mean, we are just on top of the world, 10,000 some odd feet. Selden Pass, that's where we go tomorrow. But for now, we're just going to kick back, take it easy. But what a place. Especially when there's nobody else. And there's Rolando over there. I don't know what he's doing. I think he's going to take a dip. I may join him. Okay. Adios. Thank you. Day 8, coming out of Muir Trail, heading up to Evolution Valley, following the San Joaquin River. And yeah, I'm out of breath. Been walking at about 2 mile an hour clip, and it takes it out of a man. But even this video can't possibly do justice to the absolute beauty that surrounds me right now. Just another water feature on the trail up to Evolution Valley. Yeah, this is the morning of day 9 up here at 9,400 feet, McClure Meadow. A couple days we'll be going over Muir Pass. But that's beside the point. I wanted to document some guys we met on the trail, kind enough to charge my DeLorme. And check this out, this Jotec solar charger. Very nice. There's our two DeLormes being charged. And I want to document this thing too, because it's supposed to be cool. Rav power. There it is. And here's our view of our campsite this morning. As usual, out in the middle of nowhere. And Don Rolando coming in. And, buenos dias. Yeah? And there I am. Hey. Anyway, the Jotec solar charger. Find it on Amazon. Another one. I can't believe they don't smell me. We're up about 10,500 feet, still heading to Sapphire Lake. There have been warnings not to cross Muir Pass, or if you have any kind of doubts, not to cross. There's smoke coming in from I don't know which fire, but when the wind shifts, you never know where the smoke will go. But I think you can see it on the video. Instead of crystal clear mountains, you got a haze, and we can smell it. So we're gonna get up to Sapphire Lake, where there's supposedly a ranger hanging out, and find out what the real situation is. And I'll get back to you as soon as I know something. Made it up to the top. My ass is grass. About 4:15, still on day 9. I'm gonna look for a place to camp now. I'm gonna turn the monitor thing around and show you where we are. This is Evolution Lake, and we have to skirt the edge of that, and we're trying for Sapphire Lake. Make camp there. God, I hope it's in within a half an hour or so. But anyway, here we are. Muir Pass is right about up over there. Still hazy, you can smell smoke. And I need to stick my feet in the water. Still day 9, we're on Evolution Lake. Couldn't go any further. Sun just went down over the mountain here, and I swear the temperature dropped 20 degrees in 5 seconds. So I'm gonna have to change my clothes muy rapidito. Orlando there. That's the Muir Pass. We're debating what to do tomorrow. If you can see those clouds up there, those aren't clouds. That's smoke. And we're getting gnarly reports coming out from that side of the mountain. So we got to sit here and make an executive decision. Besides that, my feet are totally screwed. Anyway, from Evolution Lake, elevation 10,700 feet, Don Pedro saying, adios. Well, here's tonight's dinner. Turkey stuffing with tuna mixed in and butter flakes for those extra calories. just about ready to dig in. This is what we are surrounded by.
Oh.
Pretty enormous. Pretty impressive. Day 10 in the morning, we're heading up to Wanda Lake from Evolution Lake. This is Sapphire Lake, and it is pretty sapphire-like, I gotta say. Very nice. Once we get around the corner up there, we'll be at Wanda Lake. Adios. About 12:30 on day 10. We've just hit Lake Wanda, where we're going to make camp tonight on the southern edge. But look at all the smoke coming in. I think you can see that. And there's going to be worse smoke south of here, exactly where we're going. So we're going to stop soon, sit down, and make some executive decisions. But there's no stopping us from going up to Muir Pass tomorrow. But anyway.
No stopping us.
No stopping us. Here's our camp at Wanda Lake. Elevation about 11,000 feet. This is where we are preparing for our assault tomorrow on Muir Pass. But we have a situation, as you can see, lots of wood smoke in the air from fires west, out of control. Right there is where we have to pass, up at 11,900 feet. At the moment, we are preparing psychologically. because it's going to be a true test of what we can do and what we can't do. Rolando, preparing mentally by relaxing, listening to tunes.
I've got no words, man.
And
it feels so good to do nothing.
Wait a minute. Hold on. That's odd.
We got one kind problem.
Your hair seems almost lustrous.
Well, that's because...
How do you maintain that luster at 11,000 feet? With no shower?
You must know. I use dioxin.
Well, it looks nice.
Thank you, Pete.
You look gorgeous.
Ah.
Did you do that today?
Yes, I did. I went to my coiffure here just below Muir Ranch.
Well...
excuse me, Muir Hut. And, yes, made my appointment. And boy, am I ready for a big night on the town.
Well, as you can see, Don Rolando is ready. I guess I'm going to have to do something. Maybe later. Right now, I'm just worried. Worried about all this smoke. Anyway, until tomorrow, here we are, preparing mentally. Day 11, about 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning, that's where we're headed. I'll zoom in here. If you can see, that's the Muir Hut.
I think I'm reflecting myself.
Right there, 11,955 feet. We will assault that this morning. That's our goal. That's Lake Wanda, where we camped last night. We are on the morning of day 11 and have reached the Muir Hut, top of Muir Pass. Let's call it 12,000 feet. Can I show you that hut right now? There it is. Rolando. Built in 1931 by the Sierra Club. House weary travelers. I feel a bit giddy. So much frisky. Away from my neighbor. And there's Rolando coming out. Oh, the hut.
And Pete's going in, for crying out loud. God knows what's in there. A blackie, a giant marmot, who knows? Hope he comes out. Haiku to follow.
What a milestone, we made it this far. It's all downhill now. Filling our water bottles here just south, 300 feet down from Muir Hut. Don't know the name of this lake, but man, that is some kind of clean water. Cleanest we've seen. Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yeah.
Gonna belly up to this lake. Yeah. Clean, cool water. Muir Hut. There's a LeConte Canyon. Trying to make big Pete Meadows. But isn't that nice? The sound, the sights. But look at all that smoke in the air. I think it's gonna get worse. But man, it's this kind of stuff that makes the 4 feet, the 8 feet shoulders, a bad knee all worth it. Right next to our camp. Here's my tent. And there's the deer. Cool. But the big attraction tonight is we have a campfire. First one. That's gonna feel nice. And it looks nice. It just makes things a bit more peaceable. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Fire. around camp, day 12, evening, with our campmates, Bill, John, and Michael. Don't have a fire tonight, but we have some nice meals going on.
Cure the stroganoff.
Good men, these three.
Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Beautiful, beautiful to see us.
With tunes.
Thank you guys for your great company.
Oh, thank you for offering the site. Day 13, 7:30 a.m. finds us breaking camp, heading over Bishop Pass. Actually, we're only going to make it about 3/4 of the way up today. It's going to be a grueling hike, 6.8 miles, up about 2,500 feet. But this is our last comfortable camp. Day 13, an ominous number. We'll soon know what day 13 brings.
Before this world was as we know it now, before the land and sea were formed at all, before the stars were made to burn and shine, little love of mine, darling one, who can pretend to understand at all? No one can both inside and outside be. Who can suppose he knows the way this goes? Little lamb, never mind.
Day 13, making our ascent to Bishop Pass. Well, my altimeter says we're at about 10,150 feet. We need to go another 1,000. Found a watering hole here, so we're refilling our bottles. And we're crossing this rickety bridge. That's from whence we came this morning, down there. Can you believe it? Still see the haze or smoke in the air. That's why we're getting out of here. But anyway, it's about 10:25 in the morning. We've got a few more hours of walking to do. So, from our latest watering hole, Don Pedro saying adios.
The world is old and it will never last. Our share of joy is in this moment past. Will you come away?
Come away.
Come away.
I think this is Dusy Basin. We're way above tree line, but there's still quite a number of stunted tree growth. Kind of meadow-like. First time I've seen ducks out on a lake. Not sure the name of this lake. My altimeter says we're at about 10,700 feet. And it's peaceful up here. Just us and the ducks. Maybe a deer or two. Thank you. marmot. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, backing off. Yeah, and what? Don't come down here. There's two more. On the south side, they've got us triangulated. They're just waiting for us to make a mistake. And our food pantry's gonna be gone. Bastards. Amazingly, we just descended that. We're still going down. A series of switchbacks that you can't see. Man, that takes a toll on a man's knee. But not his spirit. And down this way, I think these are Bishop Lakes. Right behind Don Rolando.
Feel no pain, no fear. We run downhill with the deer.
Thank you, Ron. That's where we're headed. Me and our buddy Flame and his son, the Donald.
Going all the way to Kearsarge?
Day 14, coming down to Bishop. And here he comes, Dr. Dave, the Flame Lockwood and son, the Donald.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, man. Yeah, good to see you guys. Holy cow.
Ah. Hi, Donald. How are you guys doing?
Doing good.
Best days of our lives.
Okay. Thank you. Look at this spot. Falls, beach, gravel gently sloping into a maybe 10-foot swimming hole. We can't stop. We got to make our miles.
A brutal day. How you feeling, Pete?
It's a brutal day. And I'm not kidding. But I had to show you this. Show you what we're missing sometimes because we just got to keep going, mile after mile.
Anything from John Muir come to mind, Pete?
Who?
Mr. John Muir, the man.
Yeah, yeah, he does. He may have swam here in his own self. But not today. Not today. We got miles to go before we sleep.
All righty. Pete out.
Thank you.